the king and his throne. It's Wednesday about 11:30. I mean 10:30. It's rough as bricks.
It's raining. Blowing.
This is the bay. Imagine what the ocean is like. I'll give you a close-up in a little while. I got to go out, pick up some knives. That's all I do lately is pick up knives. I'm not complaining, though. I don't know what I'm going to get today. It sounds like a guy's got a restaurant and he's got a store. It's a new place called Fruitive. And then I got to pick up a great big old wooden handle Victorinox. Like the ones I did yesterday for that lady. This one's 50 years old, the guy said. Foggy too. Oh, that's just the window fogging up the camera, I think. Okay, I'll get back to you in a little while after I see what I got. Well, me and Jack are traveling. We stopped at a light when I'm driving, so don't you guys fret about us driving, videoing while driving. I picked up one cool knife. Hold on a minute. Look at this baby. She's in a wooden case. Guy says she's 50 years old. It's a big Victorinox. Just like the ones I did the other day. Just like it's in that red bag. As a matter of fact, I'm getting ready to take them back to that lady. But this is an old Victorinox. Look, R.H. Forchester Victorinox. See, not too bad a shape. Nice big wooden handle. See, a little dull. She'll polish you up and clean up nice. I don't know about that spot right there, though. If I had some of that diamond bar, I'd be okay. I'll get some of that diamond bar one of these days. Okay, stand by the light screen. I gotta go. The other knives were from a restaurant place. Not a restaurant, so to speak. But they own a restaurant, and they have an off-site restaurant where they do a lot of the work. It's a vegetarian juice-type restaurant. They have at least 20 knives. So I picked up three little pairs and two chef's knives to sharpen them at no charge. Take them back to them tomorrow and see how they like them. And they have in their restaurant, which is in Virginia Beach, the guy said they had six or seven knives there. Could be a pretty good account. Stand by. After I dropped off the bag of red knives, I got a telephone call from a lady who lived about 10 minutes from where I dropped off the knives. She said, "Do you do scissors?" I said, "Some kind of scissors I did." She said, "Well, I need you to come by and look at my scissors." I said, "Okay." I got them. I got a million pair of scissors. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 8 pair of scissors. What do you think of that, Big O' Jack? I cut your hair off with all those scissors. Okay, so we got action on a rainy, nasty day. It's Gray Matter City. And the bay. Rough. Them ears are flapping today. The bay is rough as a washing machine. Look at that foam. This is moving some stuff around, I can tell you that. There's the Chesapeake Bay Bridgestone. There's that sandbar that makes up right over there. You can see it. Some birds feeding right there, you see them? A lot of them. Stand by. As I was saying, there's a bunch of birds feeding right there in the break in the waves. Must be some little fish or something kicking around in there. They're feeding like crazy. You see them? I mean, there's nobody down there feeding them right now, I can tell you that. They're just feeding themselves on some kind of little minnows or something. They're having a hell of a time. Whoa, baby. Jack says, let's go home. I'm freezing to death. There you go, Jack. Hey, man, I better knock this down some. Here's a multiple. You're getting zeroed right in. Come down here, you piece of crap, you. Okay. All right, first things first, there's the big old Victorinox we got today. Then, we got all these restaurant knives. Mostly Chinese tickets. Like from Sam's or BJ's. But this is just a sample of what they had. I just took a few, sharpen up, and let them see what they're going to be like. AP Craft, it looks like. Stand by. I doubt you'll be able to see it, but like I said, it says RH Forchester Company. Then it's got the Victorinox Eagle, bird, or whatever that is. Victorinox underneath of it. Stainless steel, made in Switzerland. It's got a bow and arrow, a crossbow right there. At least that's what it looks like to me, a crossbow. And right next to that eagle on the right-hand side is this extra quality. I don't know what that extra quality means, but like I said, this is a rare ticket right here. Okay, I'll see if I can get a better picture of it. Stand by. All China. Bakers and chef. These four are bakers and chefs, and that's a amp craft from China. Just cheap type restaurant knives you buy at, like I said, Restaurant Depot or Sam's or BJ's. But I see quite a few of these in some of the places I travel. They get really sharp, but the steel's not all that great. They just don't stay sharp very long. That's the only difference. Stand by. And plus, they sharpen real fast. So what else we got? All right, here's the gathering scissors. 8 pair, I think. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. It's a gathering of scissors. Like I said, little ones and big ones, hair scissors. I got plenty to keep me busy on a rainy day. Look at the wind still blowing. Man, it's nasty. All right, I got to get to work. Check with you in a little while. Well, first off, let's all start by saying everything is need of cleaning. All the scissors. Look at the rust and stuff on them. I'm not going to pick each and every pair out, just these bigger ones. They're in rough condition. Not too bad. They showed me their sharpener. They got a, I forget what model it was. It's one of them electric pull-through. It was white plastic, had stones inside of it. You pulled it through, you can see all the serrations along the blades where they sharpen them. They do a lot of cutting. And this one doesn't look like it's been through the machine. The little ones. Unless that first one got through there crooked or something. See, I don't know exactly how that machine works. Okay, you got the idea. Clean up. Polish. Sharpen. I'll get back to you. That's a scissor sharpener arm off of a Taz, a twice as sharp. I got it mounted on my Kalamazoo. Scissors clamp in here like this. I spin them around and sharpen them on the belt right here. Just like the Taz. I change belts. I don't see much difference than the Taz. Except I don't have a Taz. I just have the arm and the clamp. Okay. Dark outside. Well, I'm done. 6 knives, 8 pair of scissors. Five knives from China. And I was thinking this old Victorinox. Well, I don't know what I was thinking or where it came from. But every now and then, you run across a knife like this. This is my fourth one. I'm going to get a close-up, and I don't think, all I can see, it says made in Switzerland. I don't say any how it's made or what kind of steel it's made out of. But my buddy who has the Mayflower Cafe, the Turkish guy, he's got a set of knives that he got in Turkey when he was a young man. And I sharpened them 2 or 3 times. On the wicked edge. And the first time I sharpened them, it took, if I remember correctly, like 40-45 minutes just to get the burr on one side of the first one. I was 2.5 hours sharpening 3 of them. This chicken right here is very similar. I sharpened it on a Cali. I'm like to wore out my low grit belt. Had to switch belts. I don't know what kind of steel this is. Maybe some of you guys know. The guy says she's over 50 years old. Victorinox made in Sweden. But I can tell you one thing. She's a tough bird. But she's razor ass sharp right now. I got most of the scratches out. You can see 2 or 3 little ones right along the blade there. And there's 2 or 3 ones right there. But if I had them diamond bars, I keep talking about them diamond bars. I'm going to get them one day. I believe they would get them all at. But this is some kind of knife right here, buddy. My fourth knife like in a row. I mean, the fourth knife I've ever come across like this. I like it. Okay. I gotta box them up and do the paperwork.
See you tomorrow. Weather permitting, we'll go for a spin. Good luck to everybody.